And I'm sure that the revelations I have to make this evening, the zoo will be astonished. I'm even sure that the British intelligence services do not have what we have in our possession this very evening. And I'm sure that the Fulani Janjaweed, who are in control of Abubakar Yusuf Muhammad, the idiot from Niger Republic wearing Buhari mask, do not even know what I'm talking about. But this evening, the zoo will be shocked to understand that there is nothing they do, there is no move they make that we are not aware of. I'll be writing it down. I want the Nigerian government to know this. Nigerian government, the Chinese have promised to sell you weapons. You have moved money to Shanghai. I did not mention Beijing, I said Shanghai. Shanghai is where you are right now. Purchasing weapons from the Chinese. China have agreed to sell weapons to Nigeria. They have also signed an agreement to supply Nigeria with weapons. I did not say Beijing. I said you are in Shanghai. That is where you are right now negotiating to bring those weapons in, because you have moved Al-Shabaab to Lagos. The main strike force of Al-Qaeda is in Benue State. And the hardened remnants that you get from Boko Haram, they are now moving to the east from Bauchi. That is a three-pronged attack coming to the south. And I want Mudobel to understand this very clearly. By the time the attack intensifies in the south, nobody will remember you, you are gone. Three-pronged attack. The Nigerian government recruited three hardened terror groups to fight this very battle for them. Al-Shabaab. Al-Shabaab, they are in and around Lagos, they're in Yoruba land. They are the ones to lead the attack against Yoruba people. The main strike force of Al-Qaeda in the Maghreb, they are advancing through Benue. They will enter into Kogi. From there, they will come into Anambra and Enugu. Whereas the main Boko Haram front, recruited by this same government, they are coming from Ebonyi. But their base is in Bauchi, they are coming from Bauchi. That is where the armor, that is where the tanks are that they have given to them with which to come and kill people, because they have promised them the oil and gas in Biafra land, and that Allah gave Nigeria to Fulani people. Today's date is the 16th of May 2021. I pray to Elohim that this doesn't come to pass, but it's going to happen. And when it happens, as you people go back to this, but he said it all. He's a prophet. He said it all. Because you cannot stop what is coming. And I want you to know those to blame when they start massacring your men, women, and children. You will blame Obasanjo, you will blame Tinubu, you will blame Ojos Okalo, you will blame, I don't even want to mention the Sarikini Fulani, who is irrelevant. You will blame Richard Sokorocha, you will blame the Innamanis, you will blame Iwanyam, you will blame Mrs. Tambuwa. You will blame the likes of Ebony Clark. All these appeasers of Fulani. They always appease Fulani. They want to please them. One Nigeria. The person you are doing one Nigeria for, does Fulani believe in one Nigeria? So you think that the Fulani opening their mouth to say one Nigeria, they are doing it because they love you? Are you stupid? Are you that foolish? Not doing it because they want to conquer you. And in fact, you are conquered already. You are conquered already. Nigeria, are you not in Shanghai purchasing weapons right now, this very night? True or false, we know. When we bring them in, we are going to know. When we deploy them, we are going to know. When we destroy them in Biafra land, we will also tell you that we've destroyed them. That is to let you understand that our own intelligence is more than yours. Because in Yoruba land right now, not only are they refugees in Benin Republic, which some of them do not know, because the news is being suppressed, Yoruba people are paying ransom to go to their farms. Ask yourself this question. Somebody as influential as Wole Soyinka cannot go to his farm. He's a Yoruba man. Wole Soyinka, of course, one of the people that I blame for the mess that Nigeria is in. A man who is learning should be educating those of us, should be foretelling the dangers to come by virtue of his academic accomplishments. He was the one supporting Fulani Janjaweed. I don't know if they were doing it to spite the Igbo people, I don't know what for. That same man cannot go to his farm. Do you know somebody called Davin Anderson, the U.S. intelligence chief? He warned us how the Nigeria needs to keep its eyes open. Terror groups have taken over the region. This is the news being reported 3 hours ago. 3 hours ago, go and Google it. Southern Nigeria needs to keep its eyes open. Terror groups have taken over the region. This was what Tinubu was trying to build on IPOB. Are you following? This was what Tinubu was trying to pin on IPOB. So when Al-Shabaab are busy slaughtering people in Yoruba land, Tinubu will say it's IPOB that is doing it. But as God will have it, the love I have for Yoruba people stemming from the love they have shown to me, I'm being honest with you, we talk privately. The land of Paya, the Banjo, the land of Ghaniadams, the land of Iboho, the land of Femi Fanikayo, the land of Papa Shuranti, the land of my late friend. Why would I go and attack it? They don't know that we are under oath. Do you know we are under blood oath with our Yoruba brethren? Are you aware of that? Blood oath. That we can never ever, not in a billion years, walk against each other. Never! That is why you see their rallies. You see the way they do their rallies? That is why everywhere is bubbling. And the intelligence officer that spoke to us told us that they don't want to attack Yoruba yet. Their plan before was to attack Yoruba first. Take over Yoruba land and then come to the east to subdue us. But that the only people they fear is IPOB. Go and ask them. That is why they want to demonize us. If you're from the south, I want you to listen very carefully. If you're Biafra, if you're Biduwa, even from Indo Belt. The United States has said that the southern part of Nigeria should stay on alert because terror groups are already establishing their presence in the country and moving down south. The warning was made in a media briefing by Davin Anderson, commander of the U.S. Special Operations Command Africa. He said, Al-Qaeda is also expanding to other parts of West Africa. We have engaged with Nigeria and continue to engage with them in intel sharing and in understanding what these violent extremists are doing. Not IPOB. Al-Qaeda is there. Al-Shabaab is there. Three-pronged attack. ISIS in West Africa is there. And Tinubu wants to pin it on IPOB. Do you see how evil these men are? But our God is fighting for us. That is why we receive all. They don't even have this intelligence we do. I know where they're buying weapons now, Fulani. Fulani can never fight a war on their own. And I told that all the barracks you see in the east, they're empty. Nobody wants to join their army. That is why they're drafting people from Babuchi. If you claim that 82 division in MP is strong, OP is strong, or Hafa is strong, or Nature is strong, they are all there to intimidate all of you into submission. That the Fulanis may rule over you. That's all. There are no men. They have to go, and now they are recruiting terrorist groups to come and fight for them. You must understand what is happening. Therefore, it never came to me as a surprise. Katrina Lang, the UK High Commissioner to Nigeria, wants the Igbo race to be wiped out. The same way people want the Jews to be killed. Any day our people rise up to recognize and understand this, the better for all of us. Some people want us dead. Not that we have done anything to them. No, not at all. But because United Kingdom believes that the coming of Biafra will herald the coming of Christ, that the world will come to an end. Any day the black man acquires reason. Any day the black man can build a car. Any day the black man can feed himself. That day the world will come to an end. That's what they believe in. And they know that it is Biafra that holds the key. They understand that very well. That is why it never came to me as a surprise that after Katrina Lang visited the Axe-throat Audrey of Carlos, the very amorphous, headless monster known as Flammy Caliphate declared effectively the Second Biafran War. Something tells me, as I told you earlier, that the timing of this war on Biafra has something to do with Britain, because in like 1967, Israel today is at war, the same way they were at war when Nigeria attacked Biafra in 1967. They now want to use it as a cover to commit genocide. And I'm telling Biafrans tonight that we are effectively on our own. We have been given two choices by the United Kingdom, the slave masters and the colonizers. The UK have given us only two alternatives. And I call it the devil's alternative, of course. We either submit to the will of their puppets, the Islamic Caliphate, or we will be wiped out from the face of this very earth. The question you must ask yourself tonight as a Biafran, as a southerner, is, do you want to be a slave to the Fulani Caliphate, or do you want to die on your feet? Live for 1,000 years on your knees, as most of them are doing without even knowing it, or you die on your feet. The devil's alternative. Whichever option you choose, men are going to die. Which one do you prefer? Are we going to fight and die like men, or are we going to submit to a life of Allahu Akbar? It's entirely up to you. The time is now, because the enemies, they have come. And now, I didn't say they are coming, they have not come into our land. And as I promised them, if God is on our side, which I know He is on our side, this army of Nigeria will die in Biafra land. That is how God intended it to happen. Many of us are going to die, and I'm believing it myself, mind you. Many of us are going to die, but Biafra is going to come, and everything called Nigeria will perish in Biafra land. The world must be prepared for what is to come.